Good morning, students. Before to start with our today's topic, what we have studied in the last chapter, that is nutrition and plants. I have already told you that we were going to study the nutrition in two parts. One, nutrition in animals and nutrition in plants. Nutrition in plants we have already studied. Now, in this chapter, we are going to study about nutrition in animals. So, our today's topic is nutrition in animals. So, students, first, we need to revise what we have studied before. Yes, we have studied what is nutrition, if you remember. Yes, nutrition is only related to the food, how we are taking that food, how we are obtaining that food, how that food has been utilizing in our body, and how it is converting into energy. All these process is called nutrition. So nutrition is the mode of intake and the utilization of that food in our body is called nutrition. So students, we have already discussed about this definition. Again, now my next question is, why this nutrition is a part of our life process? Why this food is so important? We know that whatever we are doing, like we are watching this video, or we are studying, or we are playing, all these activities required what? Energy. And for this energy, we required food, which is act as a fuel for your energy. Not only this, they give us energy, but they also provide us some nutrients. If you remember, they are the six nutrients we have already studied: carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, proteins, minerals, as well as water is also being required. It is in the nutrients. Not only that, it also helps in the body building, building of our muscles, developing immunity. So food is very must. As well as we have already studied, students, that the there is a mode of nutrition. One is the autotroph, where the plants obtain their food on their own. They do not require and they don't need to go anywhere, or they don't depend on other for the foods. So they categorize in autotrophics, whereas animals, all animals do not synthesize or obtain their food. They directly or indirectly depends on the plants for their foods. So in this chapter, we will going to study the how animal nutrition and its three main steps. Number one step is food requirement or food habits. Food habit का क्या मतलब है? Food habit का मतलब है कि आप क्या खा रहे हैं? आप सिर्फ plants खा रहे हैं या फिर आप flesh या meat खा रहे हैं? So, और या दोनों ही खा रहे हैं? So that is your food habit. Second is how you are taking that food. आप वो खाना कैसे खा रहे हैं? च्यू करके खा रहे हैं या डायरेक्टली स्वॉलो कर रहे हैं या आप सक करके खा रहे हैं? तो द वे यू आर ईटिंग दैट फूड. एंड थर्ड इज इफ यू ईट दैट फूड, हाउ दैट फूड इज बीन यूटिलाइज इन योर बॉडी, दैट्स ऑल्सो बीन डन. सो इन दिस चैप्टर स्टूडेंट्स वी विल गोइंग टू स्टडी थ्री पार्ट्स: फूड हैबिट्स, कि आप क्या खाना खा रहे हैं, प्लांट्स और एनिमल और बोथ, कैसे खा रहे हैं, च्यू करके खा रहे हैं, स्वलो करके खा रहे हैं, सक करके खा रहे हैं, और जब आप खाना खा रहे हैं तो वो आपकी बॉडी में कैसे यूटिलाइज हो रहा है. वी विल गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट दीज थिंग्स, थ्री मेन पार्ट्स. नो, सबसे पहले वी विल स्टार्ट विद द फूड हैबिट्स. As we know, some plants animals eat only plants, and they are known as herbivores. And herbi means plants. So they are those animals which only eat plants. Next category here we have carnivores, those which only eat meat. Carni means meat, meat eaters. Vores means eaters. So carnivores are those animals which eat only meat or flesh. Examples you can able to see that this lion, tiger, snakes, they only eat the flesh. And the third category, that is omni. Omni means both, which eat both plants and flesh or meat. Like human beings, we can eat both. We can take the plants as well as flesh. So even crow also, hen, these are some examples of omnivores. On the basis of food habit, we have divided the animals in three categories: herbivores, carnivores and omnivorous animals. Now we will go into study how these animals take their food, that is the mode of intake of their food. That means wo animals ab apna khana kaise khate hain. So animals either they swallow the food, they chew the food, they do the nibbling or lapping. This way the animals usually eat their food. For example, like this hummingbird. You have seen the hummingbird, students. It is the smallest bird. It has a very slender or very thin beak and very long and thin beak, through which it can easily suck the nectar. Not only the hummingbirds, some butterflies, even the butterflies also suck the nectar. House flies as well usually sucks, they usually do the sucking. So their mode of intake of food is sucking. And another we have that in human beings we have a proper teeth where through which we can chew our food. And similarly the other animals also, like cow, lion, tiger, they have a very sharp canine teeth to tear the flesh. So these animals actually take mode of intake of the food is through the chewing. Ye chaba ke khana khate hain. So this their mode of intake of food is chewing. And similarly, what about the snakes? Snakes usually swallow the food. Even more than its own size, can easily swallow it. So not only the snakes, there are some insects like some animals like frog as well as lizards. Frog don't have a teeth to chew the foods. It uses its tongue. It has a sticky tongue. So it uses its tongue to trap the insect and swallow it. So this way, students, the usually animals eat their foods. And there is one more thing, is nibbling. What do you mean by nibbling? Nibbling means chewing the food in a small bites. Like, have you seen the rats? Kaise kutar kutar ke khata hai? Aise hi the same for the squirrels as well as rabbits, they used to do nibbing. So this is the way they eat the food. So we have studied there are some animals has different modes of intake of their foods. Some do the chewing, some doing the lapping, some doing the swallowing, some sucking the nectars. So these are different ways of mode of intake of their foods. So we have studied the food habits. Now next chapter, that how they are taking that foods. So every animals has their different modes to take the foods. So again, now we all have studied that all the animals are heterotrophic. They are heterotroph, means they all depend on other for their food. Now heterotroph is divided into three categories. Although we have studied this part in the last chapter also, but not in so much details. Heterotroph divided into three categories. First we have a parasites. If you remember, they are those that mode of nutrition in which the organisms derive the food from other but actually causing a harm to it. Now in the animals also they are parasites, like your mosquitoes, they are parasite, they sucks your blood. So same for the lees are on our hairs. Tapeworms also stuck to our intestines. Even roundworms, these are some parasites in animals. Second category is saprophytes. Saprophytes are those which derive their food from dead and decaying matter. They depend on other for the food, but they derive their food from dead and decaying matters. They do not harm the other students. So these are known as saprophytes. Mainly bacteria and fungi are the examples of saprophytes. All the decomposers come in this category. Last, the most important is, which is a very new for you, is holozoic nutrition. Hollow means whole. The whole food. Those animals which takes their feed by whole solid food. वो पूरा का पूरा सॉलिड फूड खाते हैं एंड गेट दैट फूड इज डाइजेस्टेड इन देयर बॉडी इज नोन एज होलोजोइक न्यूट्रिशन. एग्जाम्पल इज ह्यूमन बींग्स. वी टेक द होल सॉलिड फूड एंड दैट फूड इज डाइजेस्टेड इन आवर बॉडी इज नॉट इन दैट्स व्हाई वी कम अंडर द होलोजोइक मोड ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन. इवन ऑल द एनिमल्स, mainly all the animals are come under holozoic mode of nutrition because all they take the solid food and that food is digested in their body. So that's why they come under holozoic mode of nutrition. So students, we will going to study the holozoic mode of nutrition in details and mainly about the human beings in our next video.